Tai Tzu Ying. You probably know her. I think she's amazing. She is the master at trick shots and deceptions. And one of her key strokes in my mind is her amazing deceptive drop shot. But how to do that? Let's try to dig into that in this video. The first thing is that we want it to look like a powerful smash or a powerful clear. So we really want to show our opponents that we are adding a lot of power to the shot. So we go down and we try to add all the power towards the shot, and just before hitting it, our body goes from a very, very tightened position to a very, very loose position, and then we hit the shuttle. In that way, we will add the deception, we will trick the opponents on the other side in thinking that they need to defend a smash. The outcome of this is not to get a clear winner on this. It can, of course, be a winner. And Tai Tzu Ying also has some winners on this shot, but it is to fool your opponent just a little bit so they get out of balance in their footwork. They will probably reach the shot in a lower position, in a defense position, which will leave me or Tai Tzu Ying in a very good and solid situation on putting pressure on the next shot. So in my mind, it's actually the whole body that creates this deception. It's not only the racket and the upper body, it's the footwork and the landing in the round head side as well that does the trick for her. So when she moves to this corner and land on the left leg, her left leg also stops the movement together with the upper body. She comes down to this corner, do the rotation, and when she lands on this leg, she stops her movement almost like a robot, and then she does the smooth swing into the shot. The trick here is to get it very close to the net. And how do we do that? Well, you need to have a small angle going a little bit upwards when we hit the shuttle, and then it comes steep down just over the net, landing very, very close to the net, making it very, very tricky for the opponent to reach it all the way up there in a very pressured situation.